All right, praise you, Jesus. Hi, glad you could stop by today. So we had a storm blow in last night, and as you can see behind me, the flower didn't do so well. It's all torn up. And so there you have it. I mean, you know, you have something that you really love, or, you know, you think it's beautiful, and a storm rolls in and just crushes it and leaves it, you know, in a state that it doesn't look fixable. You know, there's no fixing that. How am I supposed to fix that, you know? So, but that's how life is, though, too. You know, the storm will roll in and it'll just, you know, it destroys your health, or it destroys your finances, or it destroys your peace in some way, shape, or form. And, you know, and that's how, and that's how it can leave us if we let it. If we lose sight of our identity and who we are in Jesus, then we lay our glory down at the feet of the circumstance. And, you know, I would just want to encourage you today not to do that. You know, if you're feeling downtrodden, if you're feeling depressed, if you're feeling hopeless, like the situation just isn't changing, then believer, I would say to you today that you should remember your identity. You are the child of the Most High. You are filled with the Holy Spirit, sealed with the Holy Spirit, justified and sanctified in the eyes of God. The very ground that you walk on is holy. You are healed from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, righteous in the eyes of God. He loves you. And because of that, goodness and favor follow me all the days of my life. And I will forever be with the Lord. Praise you, Jesus. He is good. He is faithful. But sometimes the storm can beat us up pretty bad. And we start believing what the doctor says, what the lawyer says. We start believing what the banker says. And we lose sight of what Jesus said. Jesus said that we're more than conquerors. That we are overcomers. We are the head and not the tail. We are the lender, not the borrower. We've got all these promises that are more solid than the ground that I'm standing on. But yet, if I don't pick it up, if I don't put it on, if I don't believe in it, if I don't stand in it, then I'm not going to receive it. So I would encourage you today, stand up, look in the mirror, lift up your hands, and say, I am the child of the Most High God. I am healed from the crown of my head to the soles of my feet. The very ground that I walk on is holy. I am sanctified and justified in the eyes of God, righteous. Goodness and favor follows me everywhere I go. I am the head and not the tail. I am the lender and not the borrower. In the name of Jesus. And I will forever be with the Lord. Say it, believe it, stand in it. Wrap yourself up in it. whatever it takes. You've got to get a hold of it. You got to believe it. You got to make it, you got to get that in your heart. And you'll come through this. You'll see victory in your life. You'll come through this. You just got to hang in there. Hang in there. Don't give up. I don't care how broken it looks. You know, my situation feels impossible. And as much as I'm speaking this to you, I'm speaking it to myself. Because I have to remind myself every day as well. You know, I might be the one in the video, all right? But I'm just like you, and I'm walking just like you, and I'm standing just like you. And every day that I wake up and I don't see that things are really changing, it looks just as hopeless as it did yesterday. I choose what to believe. I choose to be, I choose whether or not I'm going to allow Jesus to fight for me or not. I choose whether to lay my identity down at the circumstance or force that circumstance to bow down to the name of Jesus Christ and take on my identity and have the circumstance bow down to the name of Jesus. It's my choice. I choose. So as much as I'm encouraging you today, it encourages me just to say it myself. You are the righteousness of God. Jesus loves you. I'll see you tomorrow.